I'm Rena Nicole. I pose, I promote, and I'm passionate about our planet. I seek individuals from all over the world who are committed to making a positive impact on the world around them. So the question I have for you is, do you want to make a positive impact on the world around you? Well, do you?
Absolutely.
So I'm here at Bridgehead Studio with owner and founder Chuck DeGuida here in Alameda. So Chuck, what is Bridgehead Studio and what is it that you do here?
Well, we do a lot of things. First off, it is a studio rental for artists. It's a space for artists to be able to find their space to be able to work. I rent to mostly photographers, videographers. We have some painters, some drawers. We've had jewelers in the building and sculptors, but mostly it's photography, videography. I have a fashion designer, a couple of graphic artists. So there's about 20 artists in all that rent space here. We have meetings here. There's lots of things that go on.
Oh, really? What other kinds of things that go on here?
Well, we have a weekly business meeting for a group called Alameda Business Network. We meet here on Tuesday mornings. So it's basically a networking group for local business people to exchange business leads and referrals. We do a thing called Art Attack.
Art Attack, what is Art Attack?
Art Attack is second Fridays in Alameda. We call it Art Attack. A number of the galleries in town are open for the public to view. We curate shows mostly with local artists, and not necessarily Alameda local, but Bay Area local. Mm-hmm. We have brought some people in from outside the Bay Area, but they're usually curated by local people, Alameda, Oakland, San Francisco curators. We have guest curators. We have curators for months at a time, and then they focus on local art as well. So
having this space really has changed your life significantly.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. My life I had 6-7 years ago is completely different than what I have now. It's pretty much dedicated to making this place, you know, a useful space. Mm-hmm. This was a nasty, oily, broken up old factory that had been abandoned. So
what was the factory?
It was a propeller factory. It was called Pitchometer Propeller.
Huh.
And they made ship propellers originally for the armed forces and Navy and tugboats, and they made massive propellers. As a matter of fact, the room we're in was the machine shop. So we're sitting right where there was a big 40-foot lathe where they used to cut drive shafts for big boats.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
So this particular space that we're in right now, I mean, I noticed we have this big wooden wall behind us.
Well, I call it a barn door.
Okay.
My concept was to try and make a backdrop, a set that resembled a barn. And I had gone online looking at lots of barn doors, and I came across barn doors in Europe. And the barn doors in Europe were a lot different than the barn doors in America. They were wooden doors. They weren't painted. They weren't stained. They didn't have the white Z across them. And I really liked that because it could lend itself maybe to either the look of a winery or a barn, depending on the props that you put in front of it. Mm-hmm. But the wood that we're looking at was the wooden shelves that were in here. Upstairs was all floor-to-ceiling shelves with only about a foot in between to be able to walk through, and they were all covered with propellers. They mm-hmm. were all stacked with all these propellers. Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. And when I first took over the building, the owner was basically busting everything out and busting all this wood up. And I knew this wood was 75-year-old pine, and that's mm-hmm. virgin pine, and they're yeah. taking a sledgehammer to it, and I just stopped. I shouted stop, and I insisted that I would, you know, take them apart nail by nail. So I saved all the wood and reassembled and made these barn doors. So there's a lot of these doors throughout the building, sliding warehouse doors, all made of this 75-year-old pine that you're just not going to find. This room is called the Big Studio, and okay. it's 40 feet long, 20 feet wide. Great for photographers and videographers because it gives them a really nice long focal length. And then the doors are basically a backdrop that I created. A lot of the things in the building are backdrops. I've created I've created my backdrop so that there's sets inside the building. You don't have to create every set, and mm-hmm. this is one of them. The barn doors are they're 12 feet tall. They open up to 10 feet wide. Wow. We can actually pull cars, motorcycles in here.
Wow.
We have a loading dock, and we can move anything in here we want. So just about anything can be in this set.
Oh, that's awesome.
Yeah, it's a great room.
That's great. So this is all reclaimed wood.
It's all reclaimed wood, yes. And it's, as far as I know, it is. It's virgin pine because there was no hybrids in 1947.
Right, right. And so there's other rooms that are in this building that have the same kind of wood.
There's four big sliding warehouse doors. Mm-hmm. I think I've got them about 5 feet wide, about 8 feet tall, and they're on a rolling tracks, and those are all made out of the same wood. I made all of the baseboards and all the finish wood out of the same thing. I ripped it to different sizes to create the frame around the doors mm-hmm. and to do the baseboards with. So yeah, there's a lot of wood, and I probably have several thousand linear feet still of this wood.
Wow.
That I'll do lots of other things with.
Uh-huh. That's great. So I've noticed you have other walls in here that are made out of reclaimed materials, mm-hmm. including the very front of your building, which right. is a giant mural.
Right, right. The mural done by Isaiah Zagar. He's a mosaic artist out of Philadelphia. Laurel True at Mosaic Art Institute, or Institute of Mosaic Art, kind of referred them to do the front of the building. But yeah, it's all reclaimed tile, unused tile, some of it real old fashion stuff, some of it that came from a couple of recyclers here in town. The mosaic artist brought some with them. Mirrors that were broken mirrors that I had around here that we cut into the little strips.
Nice.
Yeah, so a lot of reclaimed stuff. There's a lot of handmade pieces in there that were made by children in ceramics classes that are on there. So yeah, so the mural is really neat. It's called Mermaid Harbor because this was a propeller factory, and across the street was a big ship harbor. So,
oh, well, there you go.
Yeah.
Quite appropriate for the area.
Exactly. And there's other things. There's doors in the building that are reclaimed. I try, if I see a construction site where there's things that I can reuse, I try and get reused things. It's difficult to reuse stuff in when you're building out a space because things have to be to spec.
Right.
So when I get a chance to do it, yeah, I try and buy used or resale items that are usable.
That's awesome. So you've taken this space and totally transformed it, and with that transformed yourself and kind of created a space where you're giving back to the community and you're supporting artists and you're also supporting yourself in this way as well. That's awesome. Yeah. Great. Well, thank you so much for your time. I really appreciate it.
Yeah, you're welcome. Thank you. Thanks for seeing us.
For more of The Rena Nicole Show, subscribe to our newsletter at www.renanicoleshow.com/welcome.